Welcome all. Myself, Mr. S.K.Kulkarni, Assistant Professor, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. I am here to discuss with you on topic Power Sector of Infrastructure. Learning outcomes of today's session are: at the end of this session, students will be able to explain status of developments in power sector of infrastructure in India. Let us see introductory part. See, there are three major pillars of power sector. These are generation of power, transmission of power, and distribution of power. Remember, these are the three major pillars of this particular sector and which is important part of infrastructure of any country. Now let us see governance of power sector. See, the power sector in India is mainly governed by Ministry of Power. Okay, and this generation of power is mainly divided into three sectors: central sector, state sector, and private sectors. Right? So each of these sectors will be responsible for generation, distribution of power. Now this central sector, which is also called public sector undertaking, PSU, okay, it constitutes approximately 30% of the total installed capacity of our nation, right? So central sector contributes to 30%, remember, to the total installed capacity of our country. Now major PSUs, that means public sector undertakings involved in the generation of electricity in our country, are NHPC, right, National Hydropower, then NTPC, National Thermopower Corporation Limited, and Nuclear Power Corporation of India, NPCIL. So these are the major PSUs, public sector undertakings, which are involved in the generation of electricity in our country. Remember. Now besides these PSUs, okay, there are this state sector approximately contributes about 42% in the generation of power. And which are these state sectors? Maharashtra State Electricity Board, MSEB, Karnataka State Electricity Board, for example, KSEB, Jharkhand State Electricity Board, JSEB, likewise. These are also involved in distribution of electricity along with generation. So state sectors are responsible for how much percentage of generation of electricity? 42% approximately in our country, right? And then there comes private sector, which also play major role in transmission and distribution, and about 30% of the installed capacity is generated by private sectors in our country, like Reliance Corporation is there, right? So in this fashion, the central sector, state sector, and private sector are there, or these are the important components of this particular power sector. Now, the Power Grid Corporation of India is responsible for interstate transmission of electricity. Remember, okay, Power Grid Corporation of India is responsible for interstate transmission. That means from Maharashtra to Karnataka, likewise. So this particular Power Grid Corporation will look after this particular transmission of electricity and development of national grid. Remember, India is third largest energy consumer in the world, right? We are developing country and we consume about 4% of global energy, remember, okay? And Maharashtra is the leading electricity generator among all the Indian states, right? And in such a fashion, India is the third largest energy consumer in the world, right? It is indication of a developing country. Now let us see what is the installed capacity and related data of 2018-19. The national grid of India has installed capacity of 367.28 gigawatt, remember, and this status is as on 31st December 2019. So our installed capacity on the 31st December of last year, 2019, was 367.28 gigawatt. Remember. Now, electricity coverage in our country is almost 97%. Right? Now, out of this, share of non-renewable, that is fossil energy, is 79.8%. And share of renewable energy is 17.3%. Remember, what is the average electricity use in our country? 1181 kilowatt hour per capita. This is per capita consumption of electricity in our country. And there are transmission and distribution losses around 21.04%. Remember, this is the data of 2018-19, right? Now, what is the consumption of electricity in our country? For different purposes, consumption will be different. These are the values of 2018-19 again. Residential consumption, 24.76%, right? Industrial consumption, 41.16%, right? This is the largest consumption in this sector. Agricultural consumption, 17.69%. Commercial consumption, 8.24%. And traction consumption, 1.52%. So these are the values which are of 2018-19. Remember, residential consumption is also marginal, 24.76, because our population is high. As well, industrial consumption is 41.16%. So these are the values of consumption of electricity in our country. Now let us see the data regarding services and institutions. Services, share of private sector in generation of electricity in our country is 46%, remember. Share of private sectors is 46%, and electricity generated in India through thermal power plants is maximum, and that is 71%. Remember, right? So thermal power plants, they use coal mainly as a fuel, right? And electricity generated through them is maximum, that is 71%, right? Now let us see which are the different institutions in our country responsible for different purposes. Responsibility for policy setting, Ministry of Power is there, right? Whatever policies will be set, those will be set by this particular ministry. Responsibility for renewable energy, Ministry of New and Renewable Energy is a separate ministry which will look after this. Responsibility for the environment, Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change will look after this. Electricity sector law, Electricity Act 2003 will be applicable. So these are important institutions, we can say, which control the activities under power sector in our country. Now let us see utility power of our nation. This is status of 31st December 2019, last year only. Now thermal power in megawatt. Now thermal power is obtained from coal as a fuel, also gas and from diesel also. Maximum share is from coal, and how much? It is this much, see, 2,07,004 megawatt is from coal, right? Generation of electricity from coal is this much. Then from gas, it is 24,937, natural gas is used. Diesel, 637 megawatt, and this is the subtotal from thermal power generation, right? 2,26,279 megawatt. Now from nuclear source, how many megawatts is possible, right? So 6,780 megawatts is obtained from nuclear power plants in our country. 6,780. We can compare now the values, right? Then renewable energy under this, from hydropower plants, 45,399 megawatts energy obtained from hydropower plants, right? And other renewable sources, 77,641 megawatt, right? Other renewable. So subtotal is 1,23,040 megawatt, right? Other renewable means under this different sources will be there, like solar energy is there, wind energy is there, likewise. Now total generation of electricity is 356,100 megawatt, and growth on annual basis is 3.52%. So we are going at this particular rate, right, per year increment in the generation of electricity is 3.52%. Now let us stop a while, friends. Here are three review questions for you. Write your answers neatly, right? First question is, residential consumption of power in India as in 2018-19 is, there are four options, write down the correct option. Total installed capacity of power in India as on 31st December 19 is so many gigawatts, write down the correct answer. Then about dash percentage of energy generated in India is by thermal power plants. So write down the correct answers. Here are the answers. Question number 1, B is the correct answer, 24.76%. Question number 2, B is the correct answer, 267.28 gigawatt. Question number 3, C is the correct answer, 71%. These are the references for today's session. Thank you.